Brethren, believers, the apostles, the prophets, and the body of Christ that has gathered today in this mighty meeting of the gathering of the watchmen. This day, I want to give you a prophetic word that God has given me an anointing to pursue the enemies to their places and devour and take back that which was lost. Now, I ask God to give me the unction to function. Now, anything that is not appreciated depreciates. I'm not going to fit in your shoes, but in God's shoes. Most of the time, we know the glory, but not the story behind the glory. This day, I would like you to be a partaker, not an undertaker. The faithful, be faithful with the vision of your spiritual father. The strength of your enemy is the maintenance of your ignorance. The enemy will allow you to see what you perceive, what you desire. Now, do not let your past mistakes define your future. You are graduating from a soldier to a general. Now, the preacher standing on the pulpit this day, anointed and full of the power, is the apostle Eliud Nzafila, and we welcome all of you to come and to listen and to hear and be partakers of this great anointing that God has placed in our midst. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give God the glory. Give God the glory. I said, you are graduating from a soldier to a general.
Before even time began, my life was in His hands. Oh, and He knows my name.
Now we are reading from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 14. Now thanks be unto God, which always causeth us to triumph in Christ, and maketh manifest the savour of His knowledge by us in every place. Now triumphant as a word is defined as to have achieved great victory. Now, the revealer of the word demonstrates how those who fear the Lord are confident that they can face their enemies. They can face situations and circumstances and win. They do not fear bad news. They are confident, and they confidently trust in the Lord to take care of them. Now, they are confident and fearless and can face their foes triumphantly. God has never lost any battle, and He will never lose one. In the book of Hebrews chapter 13 verse 8 says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. God is unchangeable. He is true to Himself, and in all situations of life, He is faithful. I call Him the keeper of the covenant. He keeps His word. The Apostle Paul declares in Colossians chapter 2, verse 15, he says, and having disarmed the powers and authorities, He made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them by the cross. Now, the enemy has been long defeated, stripped of his powers to condemn and to kill. Jesus said, it is finished to every pain, every sorrow, every defeat at the cross at Calvary.
He came so that we may have life, and life to the fullest. The God we serve is faithful. He is forever reliable and dependable. He can do far beyond our highest prayers. Galatians chapter 5 verse 1 says, "For freedom, Christ has set us free. Stand firm therefore and do not submit again to a yoke of slavery." As a believer, what does it mean to triumph? It means you are victorious and your enemy shall not overcome you. Micah chapter 5 verse 9 says, "Your hand will be lifted up in triumph over your enemies, and all your foes will be destroyed." Also in the book of Psalms 41 verse 11 says, "I know that you are pleased with me, for my enemy does not triumph over me." It gives pleasure to the Almighty God when you win against the enemy. It is a condition of the covenant. It is a promise. Abraham was told, "Out of thy loins shall come forth kings." Now, according to the kingship mandate and blessing in Genesis 49, Judah is a lion's whelp. And from the prey, "My son, thou art gone up." He stooped down, he crossed as a lion, and as an old lion, who shall rouse him up? The scepter shall not depart from Judah. He will always be victorious. These are the words of Israel, the spirit in Jacob. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verse 7, Moses' blessing on Judah says, "Hear, O Lord, the voice of Judah, and bring him unto his people. Let his hands be sufficient for him, and be thou a help to him from his enemies. The Lord is with me. He is my helper. I look in triumph on my enemies." In the book of Samuel 17:50 says, "So David triumphed over the Philistine with a sling and a stone. Without a sword in his hand, he struck down the Philistine and killed him." The Goliath that is intimidating and challenging you from advancing forward in life, bring him down and soar over it like an eagle. Revelations chapter 12 verse 11 says, "They triumphed over him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. They did not love their lives so much as to shrink from death." Goliath was called a champion. Everybody knew that Goliath was a champion. Isaiah 42 verse 13 says, "The Lord will march out like a champion, like a warrior. He will stir up his zeal with a shout. He will raise the battle cry and will triumph over his enemies." This is the victory that has overcome the world. Even our faith, the beauty is that you are an overcomer and not a loser. You are about to sing a new song. It is truism that the shouting side is the winning side. In the book of Proverbs 28 verse 12 says, "When the righteous triumph, there is great elation. I decree over you that from today you will shout in triumph in Jesus' name." Furthermore, Isaiah 58, 14 says, "Then you will find your joy in the Lord, and I will cause you to ride in triumph on the heights of the land and to feast on the inheritance of your father Jacob. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken." Knowing that God's word is forever settled, my God, the word of God is settled in your life. Nothing whatsoever will be able to overcome you. It is done. It is sealed. The word is settled. Knowing that God's word is forever settled, may you find joy in the midst of your battle in Jesus. Interestingly, the triumphant God has conquered death. Hosea 13:14 says, "I will deliver these people from the power of the grave. I will redeem them from death. Where, oh death, are your plagues? Where, oh grave, is your destruction?" Total victory is guaranteed over death. For Psalms 118 verse 17 says, "I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord, you shall not die. Death is not your portion in the name of Jesus. God has triumphed over every lack. Christians should not be in lack. God says, I shall provide. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Philippians 4:19 says, but my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. God is a God of supply. He will supply. He will not give you. He supplies all your needs, not some of your needs. With the triumphant God on your side, may lack never be known around you in Jesus' name. This God has triumphed over every impossibility. Jeremiah 32 verse 27 says, I am the Lord, the God of all mankind. Is anything too hard for me? The harder the conflict, the more glorious the triumph. With courage and boldness, your victory shall be glorious too in Jesus' mighty name.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Let the church, let them say amen. If you believe the word, let the whole church say amen. God has spoken.
In the book of James 4:7 says, submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil and he will flee. Hallelujah. Give God the glory. Give God the glory. We serve a triumphant God. You shall triumph in your business. You shall triumph in your family matters. You shall triumph in relationship. Triumph in your marriage. You shall triumph in your finances. You shall triumph. And everywhere you go, you possess. Because you serve a God of triumph. God shall triumph over your enemies. They that rise up against you, God will scatter them like the chaff of the sea, like the chaff on the air. God shall destroy your enemies from the east, from the west, from the north, and from the south. None shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. Come on, you serve a triumphant God. You serve a triumphant God. Now listen to me. I hear the Spirit of God talking to me. Now God is telling me to tell the people in the house, to tell the children in the house, to tell they that know their God. Now listen to me. God told me to tell the church to stop believing him and begin to know him. The church does not know its God. You have served God for years. You have not known God. You believe. Now, God is raising a generation, a cactus generation, a generation that knows its God. They shall triumph over their enemies. Begin to know God. Now you should cease from believing and come to the knowledge of understanding who God is. They that know their God, they shall triumph. They shall triumph over their enemies. They shall step on the neck of their enemies because you know you are God. You shall not fear. Fear is not your portion because you know you are God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.